Hi, I'm Nachiket, and today we'll take a look at Sony's latest portable console, the PS Vita. Like its elder sibling, the PS Vita packs in a total of 8 processing cores, comprising of 4 CPU and 4 GPU cores. For all intents and purposes, this is essentially a PS3 duct taped to a 5-inch OLED screen. Sony has included a comprehensive array of control options, with a multi-touch display, 6-axis motion sensing capability, and its greatest strength, a pair of proper ball and socket articulated dual analog sticks. A multi-touch trackpad at the rear lets you use touch input in conjunction with regular tactile controls. Top that off with a microphone and a pair of front and rear cameras, and you've got yourself an augmented reality gaming experience. This is bolstered further with comprehensive online multiplayer gaming tightly integrated with the PlayStation Network. Touchscreen interface, camera, microphone, and 3G Wi-Fi capability is leveraged for full-fledged social networking and communication features spanning popular applications such as Facebook, Twitter, Foursquare, and other web-enabled services such as Skype. The UMD may be gone, but Sony has introduced a new proprietary flash medium dubbed as the PS Vita card. If that wasn't enough, the device doesn't ship with any inbuilt memory, which forces you to buy yet another proprietary memory card dedicated for media storage and game saves. The user interface is touch-optimized alright, but it can't shake a stick at its predecessor's elegant XMB UI. The gaudy color scheme, daft bubble icons, and the horrid peel-over animation effects make you wonder if you're using a Chinese imitation of an Android tablet instead of a state-of-the-art Japanese console. Web surfing is quite horrible thanks to a lack of portrait orientation and a very limited frame buffer that causes annoying delays while the page sections are redrawn. The social networking aspect is quite sketchy as well, as Sony recently pulled down the Facebook application following user complaints. The OLED display is vibrant enough, but the black levels are unsatisfactory, and there's a noticeable color shift evident when the device is viewed from an angle. However, that's the least of its problems, as high reflectivity and poor brightness levels make it nigh impossible to use outdoors. Battery life is a shade under 3 hours for serious gaming, which is rather inadequate. However, my biggest gripe with the device is its inaccessible battery. I have had the PS Vita freeze on me several times, and with no hard reset feature, I couldn't resume normal functionality until the battery was drained out completely. At ₹20,000 for the Wi-Fi and ₹25,000 for the 3G version, the PS Vita sells at an average 40% premium over its price in America. As a console, it definitely has a lot of potential. However, at this price, I expect better all-round performance as a web-integrated touchscreen device. The PS Vita therefore gets 3.5 stars. For a full review of the PlayStation Vita, visit techtree.com.